Hi and welcome. I'm Pamela Harrison from Intel, here to tell you about the latest Intel GPA news and updates. The 2021.1 release has added multiple features to Graphics Frame Analyzer, Graphics Trace Analyzer, and Intel GPA Framework. For this release, for Graphics Frame Analyzer, we've made a lot of under-the-hood enhancements that improve the quality of stream capture and playback, allowing us to enable viewing multiple frames or multiple calls by default now for DirectX 12 and by toggling for the new DirectX 11 tech preview. We've added queue call markers that mark the execution start time for each GPU call in a command queue. And for better clarity in the metrics tables delta column, we now show the plus in addition to the minus signs. For Graphics Trace Analyzer, we hope you've been using and enjoying the synchronization visualization, because in this release, we've completed CPU thread synchronization visualization by adding WIN API calls. We've also greatly enhanced active thread zone visualization in Graphics Trace Analyzer. And for percentage metrics, we now default to show the full percentage range in each timeline track, though this is modifiable. It was our work on Intel GPA Framework in large part that enabled the Graphics Frame Analyzer enhancements that I mentioned. For GPA Framework, we have released a tech preview for improved DirectX 11 support and significantly improved multi-frame support for DirectX 12. In addition, we have added multi-GPU query-based metrics collection so that developers can analyze hardware metrics for applications that run on platforms with multiple Intel GPUs. To begin, for DirectX 12 stream captures in Graphics Frame Analyzer, because we improved capture playback and experiments quality, we were able to enable the selection of multiple frames or multiple calls in a frame by default. This feature existed previously, but without the underlying improvements, it was necessary for game developers to go into settings and toggle on the multi-frame profiling view selection. Now there is no need to change any settings. In Graphics Frame Analyzer, while viewing a DirectX 12 stream capture file, click on a frame in the left panel to reveal the command queue calls, including four of the most popular calls: signal calls, wait calls, execute command list calls, and present calls. If you select Execute Command Lists, which includes the render calls, and click Open, you will then be able to analyze this subset of calls in the selected frame. If you select several frames, then click Open, you will see in the API log the list of calls for all the frames you selected. You can verify at the top which frames are included in this set of data. This feature was not previously available for DirectX 11, but now we have added it as a tech preview. For DirectX 11, you do need to go into Settings and toggle the selection on for multi-frame profiling view. Also note that the feature set for DirectX 11 is limited. Second, in Graphics Frame Analyzer, our team has added queue call markers to mark the start of execution of command queue commands. Select a frame from the rendering direct queue list, then select one of the sets of calls, say signal. You can zoom in and see precisely when the call started execution. These timings can be useful for helping to understand what happens in another command queue, for example, compute queue, during frame rendering in the direct queue. To visualize this scenario, in the direct queue, select a frame, switch to the compute queue. Here, you can see that the frame is automatically highlighted in the main panel. Then you can press Open to analyze the data collected for these calls. Third, Graphics Trace Analyzer has also received a boost in functionality with our highly detailed active thread zone visualization. Notice that for every CPU thread, there is a space above the thread track. We show a green line here where a thread is actively executing and white for when it is waiting or stalled. Here, you can see that the normal blue color of a call coordinates with the green line, indicating the thread is active, whereas the lighter color blue aligns with the white space, indicating inactivity. Notice, for example, that the wait for single object call is in the lighter color. However, if you zoom in, you can see that part of that wait call is active. It is the normal darker blue with the normal darker text and has the green line over just that active part. The wait call is active here as expected because the wait call is actively initializing a Windows object to let the operating system know that it is waiting for a particular signal call. And finally, some of you use our command line tool, Intel GPA Framework. It is the back end for our Intel GPA GUI tools and also available as a separate download. This is where we did most of the work improving capture and playback and enhancing the experiment's quality that I mentioned earlier, so that we could allow multi-frame viewing by default for DirectX 12. This is also where we enabled the tech preview version of this feature for DirectX 11. In addition, Intel GPA Framework has enabled collection of the Intel Metrics Detection Library-based metrics, so that developers who have platforms with multiple Intel GPUs can analyze the hardware metrics for both GPUs. Thank you for watching. For more information about the Intel GPA 2021.1 release and to download Intel GPA for free, see the links. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for more Intel GPA news and updates.